In that 14th verse, and David danced before the Lord with all his might.
Amen.
David, you know, when you go through this Bible, the Bible said that David was a man after God's own heart.
Yeah.
But David did a lot of things that displeased God when you search the scripture. And David also penned one of the most profound texts in the Old Testament, the 51st division of Psalms. Well, he said, create in me. Let me get this. One part of my notes, but most of us didn't read it. We quoted.
All right.
David said, create in me a clean heart,
yeah,
O Lord, and renew in me a right spirit.
Right.
But it's a death to this prayer. Because David started off by saying in that 51st verse, Psalms, have mercy upon me, O God.
Mm-hmm.
According to thy loving kindness, according unto the multitude of thy tender mercies, blot out my transgression. Transgressions is wrong, evil. He said, wash me thoroughly from my iniquities. David's praying. He's talking to God about himself. Not about the preacher, the deacon, the usher, the choir member, about himself. He said, wash me thoroughly from my iniquity.
That's right.
Iniquity is evil. It's one thing to do wrong, but evil is a whole nother level.
Amen.
Cleanse me from my sins, my wrong. David. For I acknowledge my transgression.
Uh-huh.
And my sins is ever before me. Lord, I know I've done
right.
And Lord, I know that I know I've done right.
Yes.
And it will always be before me. But forgive me, Lord. Because against thee and thee only have I sinned. And done this evil in thy sight.
Right.
This is a man that took another man's wife.
Right.
We know about Bathsheba.
Mm-hmm.
Laid with her and got her pregnant.
Mm-hmm.
First of all, he committed adultery.
Mm-hmm.
David did.
Mm-hmm.
And then to cover up his sin, he called Uriah, the chief of his army, off the battlefield.
Mm-hmm.
And off the battlefield, he in war. For Uriah to come back, assuming Uriah would come back so happy to see his wife, he would go lay with his wife and sleep with his wife.
Mm-hmm.
Well, and get her pregnant to cover up the fact that David had got Uriah's wife pregnant.
Yeah. Right.
And when Uriah did not go, because in his heart was to be with his man on the battlefield.
Right.
So he wasn't thinking about his wife with sex. He wanted to be back out on the battlefield because that was in him. So when he wouldn't go and lay with his wife, David got with his top men and plotted to put Uriah on the front line of the battle to be killed. To cover up his sin.
That's right.
Ain't that something?
Yeah. Mm.
We got a nation with a lot of blood on his hands.
Well,
that police officer ain't the only one with blood on his hands. They plotted, they schemed, how are we going to do this? Let's call Uriah in. Let's put him at the front of the battle. And then they had to get with all his soldiers and say, y'all withdraw yourself. Because you know, if the President of the United States come in here right now, or the mayor of this city, his security detail will come in, and people on the street cannot just walk in because they go block it off. So in order for me to assassinate the president, the security detail got to walk away for me to have point blank range.
Yeah.
So the king, David was the king.
Yeah.
He was equivalent to the president of the United States,
yes,
the mayor of the city, the state of the government. He plotted with his people to say, put Uriah at the front of the battle, and then let all his troops withdraw so Uriah would be killed.
Yes.
Just to cover up his sin. That's deep. And then not only did he plot, after he had Uriah killed, he took Bathsheba for his wife. Compounded what he did. And then Bathsheba was pregnant with David's child. And God was displeased with David. And God killed the child. And David prayed for God to let the child live. His sin. And God, when David laid out in ashes and fast and prayed, can't pray over sin. You can't fast over sin. And when the servant came back, David didn't say nothing. They told him this child is dead. David got up because he knew what God had said was going to come to pass. That's deep. So David was praying to God to have mercy. He said, against thee and thee only have I sinned and done this evil. This ain't even in my text. I don't even know what I got. Behold, at fear first, I was shaping in this one.
Yes.
My favorite texts. I was shaping in iniquity. And in sin did my mother conceive me.
Yeah.
Then he goes on and goes down here in this 10th verse. In the 9th verse, he said, hide not thy face from my sins and blot out my iniquities. Yeah. Create in me a clean heart and renew within me a right spirit.
Yeah.
David knew I could pray all day, I could sing all day, I could dance all day, but if God did not create within me a clean heart, if he didn't change my heart,
right,
tomorrow, next week, I would be the same person back again.
Yeah.
I'll find another Bathsheba.
Yeah.
A month later. But he realized something had to change in his heart.
Yeah.
So he asked God. This is David praying to God. He said, create in me a clean heart.
Yeah.
Oh God.
Yeah.
And renew a right spirit within me.
Yeah.
Cast me not away from thy presence.
Yes.
And take not thy Holy Spirit from me.
Yeah.
This is David. 12th verse, restore unto me the joy of thy salvation.
Yes.
And uphold me with thy free spirit. Then, when you get me right, Lord, then will I teach transgressors, sinners. Transgressors go against God's word. Then will I teach transgressors thy ways.
Yeah.
And sinners shall be converted unto thee.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a prayer.
Amen.
That's a prayer.
Yes.
That's a deep prayer.
Yes,
Lord, I didn't even tell you. See, I opened my Bible for that. They didn't even get my Bible. Lord, God knows what he's doing. That's the text right there. I need to quit right there. I need to quit right there. So what happened is when David man touched the ark of God, he wasn't right. God smote him dead.
Yeah.
And David knew in his heart he wasn't worthy to allow God's presence in his house, in his heart. Keep in mind, all this is just symbol. The ark of God's presence is just a symbol of them bringing back what it left, what's supposed to be in our heart every day in the Christian walk. So David had to let it pass that time around and let somebody else get it. But David got it right and came back and got his married man and went and got the house, the ark of God, and brought it to his house with gladness. David allowed the Spirit of God to flow through his heart.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And David danced before the Lord with all his might.
Yeah.
In other words, David began to think about all that God had done for him.
Mm-hmm.
The goodness that God had begun in his life. And David began to dance. He thought about when he was a little boy and a bear came upon him.
Yeah.
And a lion came upon him.
Yeah.
He thought about when he was a little boy and he stood before Goliath.
Yes.
And everybody thought he was crazy.
Right.
And then when God gave him the victory, they struck out a song and said, Saul has slain his hundreds and his thousands, but David slew Goliath. God had given him favor in the eyes of the people.
Yeah.
Well, magnified. So David began to praise God when he realized that God had been with him and kept him. Kept sickness away from him, kept death away from him, watched over his children. Kept him when he didn't know how he was going to make it.
Well,
David began to reflect over all of those things. And he began to praise. He praised God till he took his robe off and danced out of that robe. He danced out of his clothes.
Yeah.
He danced till he was naked, dancing before God. Because the Ark of the Covenant had come. The presence of God had come back to David's house.
Yeah.